take some of that idli chutney and simply place it in your mouth. That idli magically disappears on your palate. There's tons of ghee that goes into making a kesari bath, and you can definitely taste it in its lush richness.
Idli, vada, upma, kesari bath. That's how you got naal kaitam ide.
And coffee.
And coffee. You can't leave Brahmin's coffee bar without having coffee, of course.
Hi folks, hope you're doing well. And welcome to another episode on the Gourmet on the Road takeaway series. Well, things are opening up here in Bengaluru. We're just crossing Lalbagh Park, which is the city's largest park. And the parks have opened as of today. So they're open for 2 hours in the morning, 2 hours in the evening, just for people to go out and get some exercise, hopefully. Rickshaws have opened and so also buses. So the city is opening up, albeit cautiously, going by the less traffic that you see on the road. So today we're on our way to Shankarapura here, not too far from Lalbagh Park, and we're going to be visiting Brahmin's Coffee Bar. Now Brahmin's Coffee Bar is perhaps one of the most popular idli destinations here in South Bengaluru. We've done a complete episode on them a few months ago. If you haven't caught the episode yet, I'm going to place a link to that episode right here. Now Brahmin's Coffee Bar is an establishment that's over 50 years old, and they serve the softest idli that you will find in Bengaluru. Other than the idli, they serve only three items, which is the vade, a kesari bath and a khara bath. So we're on our way to Brahmin's Coffee Bar to see how they're doing, how they're coping with things, and also get a taste of their idli, vade, khara bath and kesari bath in takeaway mode. This place is a far cry from the last time we visited. There was absolutely no place to park. There were bikes all over here, and there were people milling all over just to get a taste of the legendary idli served here at Brahmin's Coffee Bar. But today is a different scene altogether. So people aren't allowed in today. There's social distancing markers for people to stand. Let's go and see what's happening at Brahmin's Coffee Bar and see how they're coping with life in the new normal. So that's Mr. Radhakrishna Adiga, owner of Brahmin's Coffee Bar, along with his family.
With a lovely staff.
So how are things, sir?
In spite of the COVID, I think we are having about 30+% of the business.
Okay.
As long as public is supporting us, we are always better. So business is normally coming very normally, day by day it is going up.
So what is it that you're doing at Brahmin's Coffee Bar?
We are giving only parcels, only okay. Takeaway with the support of Swiggy and the Danko, and our regular customer come with their own vessel.
So mate bere ni olage in steps takolta idira
olagade nu ella hudugru sanitizer use maartta idivi
okay.
Ellaru gloves hakidivi ellaru mask hakondidivi and every 2 hours we are been putting all the phenyl and tables are very clean, very clean.
So of course it's a very simple system here because they have only 4 items.
Yeah, idli, vada, upma and kesari bath.
Idli, vada, upma, kesari bath
and coffee.
And coffee, of course. You can't leave Brahmin's Coffee Bar without having coffee, of course.
Some of them are not very happy. They say that we come here to eat fresh, but we can't go home, and sometimes we are on the way to our office and work. How can we sit or somewhere else? There is no place to eat also. We are not allowing them to see, even eat it in the car also. That is the major difference.
So people cannot eat in the car. They have to take the food strictly and go away.
Parcel means it is strictly parcel. They are not allowing. So that is the biggest challenge for us. So like this we pack it.
The one thing about Brahmin's are your soft idlis. So when people eat it here, of course it is soft, but when they take it home, is it still the same?
It will be soft, but only thing is the difference is hotness, that it will be cold. That's the only problem.
So do you suggest that people steam the idlis?
Yeah, they can steam it and eat it.
What about the vade? Vade is a challenge.
Vade, we keep it outside. We will not keep it inside the idli along with that.
Okay.
So the crispiness will be there for almost 1 hour. Even though it is cold, the crispiness will remain for 1 hour.
Yes.
Yeah.
ಸೊ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಡೆಲಿವರಿಗೆ ಬರೀ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ವಡೆ
ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾರಾಬಕ್ಕೆ ಆಲ್ ದ
ಕಾಫಿ ಕಾಫಿ
ಕಾಫಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಗಿವನ್
ಓ ಇಫ್ ದೇ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಫ್ಲಾಸ್ಕ್ ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕಾಫಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ಲಾಸ್ಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಟುಡೇ ಅನ್ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ಲಿ
ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಕಾಫಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್
ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಕಾಫಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಔಟ್ಸೈಡ್ So this is Mr. Chandrasekhar, the oldest customer here, has been coming for the last 38 years.
And the first customer every day.
The first customer every day at 5:59. 5:59 a.m. They open at 6 a.m. But he is here at 5:59 a.m. ಈಗ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನು ವ್ಯತ್ಯಾಸ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದೆ He doesn't find any difference in the food. Of course, he has to come here and take his food away. He says the hygiene is there now, it was there then. Of course, today it's a lot more visible in terms of masks that everybody is wearing, gloves, sanitizers that you find. But he says the food is still the same. Thank you, sir. Thank you. More plate idli kodi. Two vadas. Give me two karabat, two kesari bat. And give me two coffees. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. I know. One is so used to wearing the mask that I was just about to raise the cup to my lip, forgetting that I have my mask on. So let's find a little corner and enjoy this Brahmin's Coffee Bar coffee. Nothing beats the joy of having some hot coffee standing right here at Brahmin's Coffee Bar. The coffee is strong. I always ask for mine without sugar or very less sugar. Thereby tasting the bitterness of the coffee in its full-on intensity. So they do a special blend of coffee here, which gives it its unique flavor and character. I guess we'll have to slip our mask back on in between sips of the coffee. The idli parcel has the gatti chutney, the firm chutney. But what he's also given me is that slightly liquid chutney, which is normally served at the chutney counter here. There are some traditions we have to continue. And that extra chutney is that one tradition of Brahmin's Coffee Bar that we should continue. So let's go home and taste the tiffin from Namma Brahmin's Coffee Bar. Let's go. Well, time to unwrap our Brahmin's Coffee Bar bundle. The only challenge though is I have all these bundles and I don't know what's in them. So if you're wondering about all the food that you see out here, well, I always like to bring something extra and, you know, share with people around here. And that's what we do. Not just in the house, but also outside. You know, people who help us in many ways. I'm going to heat that idli a bit in the steamer. Well, we are ready to tuck into our Brahmin's coffee takeaway. So I have my idlis here. The idlis that we have steamed. The one thing that's very distinct about the Brahmin's Coffee Bar idli is the texture of the idli. You can see that this is an idli that's quite porous. It's not an idli where the grains pack in tightly. In fact, it's quite porous. And I think that allows for that chutney to seep into that idli. I've got two idlis here, and then of course we have the vade. Now the vade is a challenge when you're eating in a takeaway, so I can already sense that this vade is cold. You know, when you heat this vade, and unless you're doing it in an oven, in a convection oven, but that's too much of an effort, the vade tends to lose its texture. So I'm not going to heat the vade at all. I can sense that the vade is crisp on the outside, is crisp to the touch. And then of course we have the chutneys here. We have the gatti chutney. And we also have that telu chutney, the chutney which is more watery. And then of course, we have the uppittu here, the karapat. The karapat at Brahmin's Coffee Bar is embellished with all sorts of goodness. So you've got some coriander, curry leaves, there are some lentils that have gone into it. It's quite a flavorful karapat from my last time eating this at the restaurant. And then you have the kesari bat, which has a plump raisin that's sitting on top of that delicious, sweet, ghee-laden mound. I'm going to make some place on my plate and get some of that gatti chutney first.
and go for that idli. I want to taste the idli first, just as it is. Although I've steamed the idli, it loses its temperature quite quickly, so it's fairly warm. But as you break into that idli, you can certainly tell that this is a delicate idli. It breaks away so easily, it crumbles away almost. There's a tart edge of the fermentation, but that idli is porous. You can feel every grain of that idli on your palate. Well, time to taste the idli with the chutney, the gatti chutney. I'm going to go for a generous measure of that chutney. The idli takes on a spirited personality with that chutney. I love that chutney. It has the coconut, the chilies, which gives it a nice spicy bite. And also, this has the urukadle, or the roasted chana dal, which gives it a grainy sort of a mouthfeel. I love the spicy fervor of that gatti chutney. I'm going to take the chutney and quite literally cover the idli with the chutney. You taste that salty, spicy kick of that chutney as it smothers the idli. And then towards the end, you taste the grainy tart bite of that idli. What I want to do next is pour this other chutney on top of my idli. I want to drench the idli with this runny chutney. This chutney is slightly different from the gatti chutney. You can taste more of the coconut, the curry leaf, the mustard seeds that have gone into it. But because this is a runny chutney, it will permeate every pore of that idli. This idli is now yielding to the slightest of pressure. It's disintegrated as if reconstituting itself to embrace, to get all of that chutney. And that's the Brahmin idli that melts in your mouth. You don't need to chew on it at all. All that you need to do is take some of that idli chutney and simply place it in your mouth. That idli magically disappears on your palate. And to this coconut chutney, I'm now going to bring in some of that gatti chutney. The gatti chutney has more of a spicy kick and also that grainy bite because of the urukadle that's gone into it, the roasted chana dal. And the runny chutney, or that liquid chutney, is more aromatic in the flavors. The flavors of the curry leaf, the bite of that mustard seed, and also I think there's a mint that's gone into it, very little mint. So here we have it, the idli with both the chutneys. You can barely recognize the idli in this bite. All that you can see is a white mush coated with the chutneys. Mushy it may be, but a delicious mush at that. As that idli slithers down your throat, all that it leaves behind is the flavor of that curry leaf, the heat that comes from the green chili, and a bit of the mint that's gone into this chutney. My last bite of the idli, so I'm going to make it count with some of that chutney, with a curry leaf that I've crested on top, and some more of that gatti chutney. A messy bite, but a delicious one at that. Time now to move on to that Uddina Vade. It's a tough act for this Uddina Vade in its cold avatar to follow that creamy melt in the mouth idli, but let's give this a shot nonetheless. So this is an Uddina Vade that's quite well embellished. You've got some curry leaves outside, some green chili inside. I think there's also some peppercorns. You know, when the Uddina Vade is hot, it's crisp. But when it becomes cold, it turns into an almost spongy sort of a texture. And that's what I can feel in this Uddina Vade. But I'm hoping that the flavors are still what they used to be. Although it's not crispy, there still is a bit of a crunch as you bite into that Uddina Vade. And it's a flavorful Uddina Vade. You definitely taste the wholesomeness of the lentils and the bite of the pepper and flecks of fresh coconut that have gone into that Uddina Vade. I'm going to get some more of the chutney to savor with that Uddina Vade. Take that Uddina Vade and mop up that wet chutney first.
You want to make sure that you soak up all that chutney with the vade. And once you're done with that, get some of that gatti chutney just to give it that added flavor zing. That's a cold vade. I'm definitely missing that crisp bite when you bite into a hot vade. But given the circumstances, I'm quite enjoying this vade, even with its whisper of a crunch. There's also some chilies that have gone into this vade. And when you bite into that chili, it certainly makes for a warming spike. What I want to do next is soak up that vade with this chutney. I love the bite of the coconut that's in the vade and the grainy crunch of the coconut, the fresh coconut that's in the chutney, and that chili spike of the bits of green chilies. The last time when I was at the restaurant, I was eating in a bit of a hurry. But right now here, when we're sitting at home, enjoying the idli vade and all that chutney and also that extra chutney, I'm enjoying the chutney at leisure. And therefore, it's twice the fun. Or as someone in the north will say, double maza. Delicious. I'm quite tempted to go for some more idli vade. But I think I'll control myself because I still have to taste that kara bath and kesari bath. I've heated both the kara bath and the kesari bath in the microwave for about 30 seconds. And so without any further ado, we're going to taste the kara bath before the kesari bath. What I love is the way in which this kara bath is studded with all sorts of deliciousness. So I can see some curry leaves. I can see some toasted lentils. There's some coriander that I see here, some mustard seeds, some coconut flakes as well. And I think also some chili somewhere there. So even before you taste this kara bath, you know this is going to be a flavorful, savory dish. I can also see some onions in the kara bath. Oh, I love this. I think there's also some lemon juice that's sprinkled over the kara bath. So you can certainly taste that edge of a saatwang as you taste this kara bath. There's a full-on play of flavors in your mouth. You're tasting that yielding sweet bite of the onions, that toasty herbaceousness of the curry leaves. There's some coriander stalks as well that have gone into it, and it conveys a zesty freshness when you're tasting it. And then of course, that bite of the coconut and also that soft crunch of the toasted lentil seeds that have gone into this semolina preparation. This is a tasty kara bath. You know, this kara bath is so flavorful that you can eat it just by itself. But out here, we love to eat our kara bath with some chutney, and that's what I'm going to do. That chutney further accentuates the flavor of the kara bath. Well, kara bath done, it's time to move on to the kesari bath. My favorite way to end a South Indian tiffin. I'm going to make sure that I get one of these plump raisins onto this spoon. There's tons of ghee that goes into making a kesari bath, and you can definitely taste it in its lush richness the moment you place it on your tongue. And then this kesari bath is all about the pineapple and clove when it comes to flavor. But when it comes to its texture, alongside the semolina, there is also some vermicelli that goes into this kesari bath, which makes for a perceptible bite on your palate. Of course, you also have tiny dices of pineapple that's gone into it. I wonder who thought of adding pineapples into this dish. Whoever that was, I must say it's a stroke of genius. Because what that pineapple does is that it lends its acidity to this sweet dish, thereby also toning down the sweetness of the kesari bath. And every once in a while, you'll bite into a clove that's softened by the sugars, that's softened by the ghee, which will help to further cut
the sweetness on your palate. You know, it's a dish with very few ingredients. So you've got the rava, the semolina, you've got some vermicelli, you've got chopped pineapple, you've got cloves, you've got raisins, and oodles of ghee. But each one of those ingredients works together to create that harmony of flavors and textures as you savor that delicious kesari bhat. I've quite enjoyed this breakfast. To be honest, I wasn't expecting to enjoy it as much. You know, because when it comes to South Indian tiffin or South Indian breakfast dishes, they don't travel well. They tasted best when you are at the establishment, when the idli is just taken off the steamer, placed on a tatte, some chutney ladled over and then served to you. But that's not going to happen, and it doesn't look like it's going to happen anytime soon. So the next best thing is a takeaway. But come to think of it, the dishes that I tasted here were as enjoyable given the circumstances. All that I had to do was warm up the idli a bit in a steamer, and with that gatti chutney and the telu chutney, it was an idli that melted in your mouth like the idli would have at Brahmin's Coffee Bar. Of course, the vada takes the brunt of the punishment because that vada loses its crispness, but you can still redeem its flavors by dunking it into copious amounts of the chutney, because the vada is still as flavorful with the curry leaf, with the pepper, with the chili, and with the goodness of the lentils. The kesari bhat and the kara bhat are two dishes that thrive in this takeaway mode. All that you need to do is heat it a bit, and I enjoyed both of them thoroughly. In fact, I still have some kesari bhat on my plate that I plan to savor leisurely. It was a very different Brahmin's Coffee Bar as opposed to the last time we were there. If you haven't caught that episode, do look up that video. I'm going to place a link in the video description. But what's endearing, what's interesting is the fact that the owners and the staff are still in great spirits. And that's the need of the hour. No matter what the circumstances, as we step out to go about our day-to-day work, I think it's important that we preserve our spirits. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Until the next one, stay safe, stay very, very safe, and happy eating. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!